Welcome back to your free training course for Windows 7. In this video, I will look at folder virtualization. Although this is the correct technical term, you will often also hear folder virtualization referred to as libraries. This is because Windows Explorer uses folder virtualization to create libraries. Libraries allow the user to have a collection of files in the same view. These files may exist on the local computer or on the network. For example, on your network, you may have a number of templates that are stored on different servers on your network. You may also want to give your users the option to create their own templates and store them on the local computer. Using folder virtualization, you can group these items under the one place. You also have the option to make these files available offline. Having data on a server means it is easy to back up with the rest of the server. This also allows roaming. Roaming is a feature that allows the user to have the same settings and access to the same documents, regardless of which computer they log on to. You also have the option to make these files available offline. Using offline files means that when you disconnect the computer from the network, which is common with laptops, a local copy of the file is still available for you to use. This feature can also be used to assist roaming users. To demonstrate folder virtualization and how it is used in libraries, I will first open Windows Explorer and show you the libraries that are created by default on Windows 7. Here you can see under Libraries the folders Documents, Music, Pictures, and Videos. To create a new library, right-click Library and select New Library. This library I will call Templates, and will contain templates on the local computer as well as templates on the network. Since the library has just been created, when I select it, I will need to select the option Include a Folder. From here, I will browse to the My Templates folder I have created on the local computer to store user templates. If you select the Options folder at the top right-hand corner, you can change the way the files are arranged on the screen. Notice the option At Present related to General Files. This will show files based on the date the file was last modified, types, and their name. To further customize my library, I will select the library and go into the properties for that library. I will now select Include a Folder to add a folder on the network drive. Notice that if I select the newly included network drive location, I can also select the option Set Save Location. When saving files to this library, Windows will now favor the network rather than the local computer where possible. The option below this allows you to change how the library is optimized. Since this library will contain templates, I will select the option Documents. Notice in my library a list of files is shown for each of the folder locations. If I again select the Arrange option, the options have changed because I made that change to the optimization settings in the Properties section for the library. If I select the option Names, the library is now shown as a list of files with the location of these files not shown and thus totally transparent to the user. Using libraries, you can group files together from many different locations, making it easier for the end user to locate files. This concludes folder virtualization. In the next video, I will look at new features in Windows 7 called Home Group. Home Group allows home users to share files with each other easier than ever before. For more free videos and free exam questions for Windows 7 and Windows Server 2008 Release 2, remember to have a look at our webpage. Thanks for watching.